How's it going, YouTube? And welcome to another video. So today we are playing another free Steam game. So this one's called The Port of Call. I'm excited to see what it's like. Alright, so here we are. I like how the water is almost better animation than the rest of the game. So you got a lighthouse in the background. Some lady here. Not here. Alright. Is this a horror game?
Oi!
Oi, you there. You're late. Late for what? You know perfectly well why you're here. I'm bored with you. Come on now, get. Alright, a boat. Alright. Hello. Here's that guy.
Oi.
Alright, to business. I assume you know how to do your job. Get to it then. I'm the captain here of this hunk of scrap, and I will have no more dilly-dallying. What are you talking about? Great, they sent me another idiot. I haven't the time to hold your hand while you learn to pick your nose. I have a ship to run. I guess you could start out with a simple task, though. That's not too hard for your wee little brain. There's a little girl in the first cabin on the left. Get her ticket. The little brat won't come within a foot of me without squealing like a babe. Come back to me when you're done. And if you're feeling a bit lost, feel free to come back and chat. What the heck? So you got a floating book here? Whispering is always so creepy. Okay, here's the girl. Don't eat me. Oh, who are you? The boogeyman sent you. Are you going to eat me? I'm not gonna eat you. I'm here for your ticket. I'm not a kid. I hate when Marcus calls me that. I'm almost 6 and a half, thank you. Are you a scary friend of the boogeyman? He's a grouch, but he's not a monster. He stumps around and makes weird noises. That's scary and weird. Speaking of... let's do the nice one. Not sure, think about it makes me feel funny. Oh, I was playing with Ted's. Who's Ted's? Ted is the bestest bear in the world. He's my best friend. Last time I saw him, we were playing together and hiding from Marcus. Could you find Ted's? So I'm assuming Marcus is her older brother. So we need to find her bear? Cup. Alright. Nice. We got the bear. There's your bear. I miss you so much. The last thing I remember is me, Marcus, and Ted's were playing together when Mom and Dad were gone. Who's Marcus? Marcus is my big brother. He's nice and funny and silly and a dork. We were playing hide and seek when... The three of us were playing hide and seek. Marcus, Ted's, and me. Marcus was the seeker. Ted's had a great idea for a hiding spot, so I listened to him. Where'd you hide? We went to hide with the rest of Ted's friends in the toy chest. I climbed in, but the lid fell down shut and it got dark. I got scared. The wooden lid was too heavy. I couldn't lift it off. What happened next? I called for Marcus as loud as I could, but he didn't come. It was so dark and I couldn't breathe. And then it hurt. That's fucked up. Why didn't Marcus find me? Yeah, he always liked being seeker. I just didn't know why he didn't find me. Do you think he wanted to find me? I couldn't tell you. All I know is that you're here now. I guess so. I just wanted to see him again. Maybe he's still looking for me. That's creepy. I don't like that. Just picked up a crayon. Should I collect all the crayons? Cerulean. Alright, there's her ticket. Any more crayons I can grab? A lollipop. Maybe the old man wants a lollipop.
Mm-hmm.
You got your first ticket. I guess you're not completely inept. Little girl made it sound like she was dead. Yeah. And what of it? Oh, don't tell me you feel sorry for her. See, here loads of kids off it every... Okay. And you don't... Wow. Why would she be any different? Who was she? It looks like I care. It doesn't matter. She's dead, and so is most everyone on this wreck. And I suppose... Am I supposed to have a bleeding heart? Every time some kid shows up here with a sob story... Bah. Anyway, you got another job now, laddie. Use the lift at the end of the hallway and go talk to the drunkard at the bar. I can't understand this thing the fat man says. I don't have time for any more of your stupid questions. So we're in a bar now? Where is everyone else?
Huh?
What? Not now, I'm waiting for the bartender, young man. I wish he'd get here soon. Looks like I have to pretend to be the bartender. Can't let a man drink without some music. The crowd next to you. Yeah, the crowd next to you. Why don't we get a song playing? Alright. I like it. Drink to this song. Now this is fine.
Oh,
oh, there you are. What kind of service is this? I've been waiting ages, you know. What are you talking about? The ferryman sent me. That old curmudgeon must have gotten sick of my nagging. Well, how about it then? Want to serve an old man a drink? I'll play along, I guess. Let's see, how about we start with something simple? Yeah, a gin and tonic will do nicely. Alright, what do we got here? Not your pop soda pop. Simply quinine. William Orange. Potato Riot. The Bearded Sailor. And Juniper Delight. Well, quinine, that's gonna be tonic. Potato. What's made out of potato? Vodka? Bearded Sailor is probably going to be a whiskey, and then, yeah, they flavor gin with juniper, right? Alright, perfect. In a cup form? No? Maybe? Yes? Okay. Now then, why don't you tell me about yourself? Didn't your pop ever teach you how to drink? What good's a fine spirit if you don't chase it with good company? Fair enough. You know you make a mean G&T kid, but you lack the personality of a bartender. Come on. Surely you have at least a few questions. I don't even remember my own name. Oh, I wouldn't worry too much about that. Being like that have a tendency of floating back around. Get it? Floating? We're on a boat. Anyway, I think it's time for another drink. Why don't we get a little fancier? How about some vodka and orange juice? How is that more fancy? So, William Orange, potato, yep, juice and vodka. You moved over. I'd tip you, well, if I had any money. Jukebox is going fucking crazy over there. Now, what are we talking about? The fairman told me everyone was dead. We don't look quite dead to me, son, but if that's so, you're pretty good company. Most everyone on the ship's been for some time now. Well, except for the Grouch in the raincoat. No one's quite sure about him. How can I tell if I'm dead? Now, that's one question only you can answer. It's different for everyone. Give us some time, though. I'm sure you'll figure it out. Remember how you died? Now, that's a short story I've not told in a long time. And not one with a particularly happy ending, obviously. Are you sure you want to hear it? Sure. I had a daughter once a long time ago. Suffice to say, she died in an accident when she was young. Wonder if he's the dad of that girl. My wife followed her soon after, died of a broken heart, I guess. It was only me and my son then. Well, I took to drinking. It eventually did me in. Now how about another drink? Old-fashioned rum and cola. All right. Here's a soda pop and some rum. That's some strong drink. Thanks, Marcus. Are we Marcus? I'm gonna take a nap now. Wait, what did you... Sir. Grab his ticket. And who the hell is this? Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, I see you got the old drunk fool's ticket. Good job. I don't have the time to humor your fancy right now. The choppy waters require my full... Wait a minute. What the hell's...
Oi!
Well, you there, get off my bow. You're blocking the view. Bloody girl's not listening. Get out there and get her to move. Yeah, she's blocking the view real bad. Hello. You're the first person I've seen on the ship who doesn't look dead, but your face is blurry. Why are you here? I could ask you the same question. I'm here to collect your ticket. Excuse me, lady. I need your ticket. I've waited here so long I've forgotten the need to speak. I'm waiting for somebody to board the ship, so I've been holding on to my ticket. I'll do the lighthouse one. I don't see a lighthouse over there. Just another sunny day over blue water. Everyone sees things differently on this ship. That's interesting. Have you tried walking around talking to people? I've spoken with everyone I know on the ship. There are innocents, delusionals, and pessimistics. I believe one is a shadow of a person I'm looking for. Are you talking about the black silhouettes on the ship? I mean a shadow in a more figurative way. Those people you cannot see are people you do not know. Interesting, I like that. This person is someone I know, but he is not his whole self. Skip that, alright. Yes, he is missing a large part of himself. His shadow feels like the embodiment of negativity. His mask haunt me. Did this person help you remember who you were looking for? I didn't speak to him that long. He didn't have anything helpful to say, mostly hurtful. I could not see his face, but he was wearing a mask like the others. He does not sound very nice. I don't think I met the guy. He is not very nice. I don't think you would have. He's below the main deck in the boiler room. How did you get down there? The lift only goes up. The elevator's a little strange. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Could you help me get down there? If only I could. I can hardly move anymore. This mask weighs on me so. What does my mask look like? You don't have a mask. You're very different. There's nothing guarding your face, and you almost seem alive. I couldn't tell you if I'm dead or alive. Think, who was it you were looking for? He was the one who waited with me in the hospital. I don't know how long I've been here, but it seems like I'm more familiar with the ship than any place else. I see. Can you remember anything else about him? Yeah. When I think about him now, I see the mask of the man in the boiler room. I don't know why it would torment me. Maybe the ferryman has the answers. No, he cannot help me find the boiler man. I'm not going to last much longer. Marcus. So, I'm beginning to think that the guy we're playing is the Marcus who... basically let his sister die, and that was his dad up there. I don't know who that lady is though, maybe the mom? But let's go see the boiler room. We got another crayon. Oh, achievement unlocked, crayon hoarder. Apparently you can get crayons in the afterlife. Alright, creepy man. At the end of his time, the man from the boy finally emerges. But is he a coward still, or will he face his wraith? Will he let sands trickle out, or Has he the courage to turn back the hands of fate? Who are you? Me, I am no one of importance. I am your dearest love? I am a memory abandoned, a guilt you can't forget. I am every virtue you hold dear, a monument to all your sins. What is it, like the embodiment of your sins? Asked, who are you? You seek the answer you already hold. You ask the question whose answer you do not wish to know. Or perhaps the query you want is yet another still. Okay, riddles. Who becomes what, and closer you come to your quest fulfilled? In that case, who are you? You do not recognize the reflection gleaming in the dark. An embodiment of all your sins, all your pain, all your guilt stares back from the abyss. The ferryman wants your ticket, and like a pawn you move where he commands, without a thought or reason or overall plan. Do you wonder at all the reason might be that saw you wake up on a deck at sea? Oh, that rhymed. I have been asking, I've asked everyone on this godforsaken boat, and no one can give me a goddamn answer. Perhaps a small mercy they granted onto you, but no such compassion will I bestow upon a craven such as you. The answer you sought, I give to you now. A shattered soul taken to an edge, slickened wrist brought to an end. But this is the end. But is this the end of a story or the start of another? Most likely the former, as I see no hope for the latter. Shattered soul, slickened wrists, what are you implying? With all the pieces before you, one might think you a bit slow. It was your hand that slew you, yet not that alone. And by your hand, the others also found themselves here. I didn't murder them. I'd never murder anyone. Nothing so crude, but in the end, just the same. An action can be just as strong as action. Knives are not needed to cause pain. The sister, dead of neglect at age 6, the father drowned in a cup, with only his son to blame, and finally the woman waiting for the man who never came. Lily, recall the whole story, Marcus, before you say that again. You were in charge of her, something you resent, had Big Brother watched her. As he promised he would, she would not have been dead in a coffin taken too soon. But that's not true, I always took care of her. All this had a lie the teller believes, but in the end you may fool yourself, but you cannot deceive me. So let the weight of the truth crush you underneath. You alone are responsible, guilty, and culpable. You're right, I abandoned her. You still have questions and I have answers. The father down in a cup. So, yeah, the drunk man was his dad. Of course, who else could he be? But was he a loving father or an uncontrollable... Debauchee? In the bar, he said he drank himself to death. And while the truth that might be, there's a certain irony still. To the great beyond, the child follows the father. To once again offer the cup that killed him. Oh, that is really ironic. I didn't know, I wouldn't have given it to him otherwise. Alright, one more thing, the woman. I'm the one the woman was waiting for? Yes, the woman who once professed love to now waits in the grave. Awash in the masquerade of beyond. You paid dearly to be able to see her again. Ignorant of the results of your actions would spawn. Alice called you a shadow of the person she was looking for, what did she mean? Through it stares you in the face and you still not see. Flip a coin in the air and watch as it spins. One side shows you, the other side, me. I'm everything you hate, all you regret. Woven into one person, your greatest laments. You're me, and Alice was my wife, I remember now. And it seems that the need for me is done. Though I do not believe you have one more thing remains before you reach... end. go to the woman, speak to her, and leave nothing unsaid. Alright, so this had a really interesting turn. The lighthouse is... Oh, the lighthouse is there now. So it looks like I've got an option. So speak to the woman, that's what he told me to do. Talk to her first. It's you. I can see you now. Do you know who I am? Yes, Marcus. It's always been you. You found me. How did you come back? Everything went dark, and then I heard a voice. It was you. You brought me back. But now you need to make a choice, Marcus. We're at a crossroads. What choice do I have? You're special, Marcus. I hope you know that. I do. You're both part of this world and the world we both came from. But it can't be that way once you walk through those doors. One of these doors. I won't hold anything against you. I love you, and I know I'll see you again. If you take the door closest to me, it will travel to a life beyond with everyone you met on the ship. Are you going to go back to the world of the living through the lighthouse, or are you going to go through the left and stay with me and the others? Oh, that's a really hard choice. What's he got to say? Well, the cat's out of the bag now, laddie. There's no happy ending here, no sailing off in the sunset. You have a choice to make, but I don't envy you one bit. Know that if you choose this door and go back to the world of the living, there might not be any coming back here. I can't idle by and wait for you forever. Next time you come back, there might be a different ship, or maybe there won't be a ship at all, I don't know. The afterlife is funny like that. Anyways, you have a choice, and I can't sit here forever till you choose. Go on. That's really hard. Like, I feel like the selfish choice would be to go through the lighthouse, and that's the type of person Marcus was in his life. But I also think me as the player, he doesn't deserve that. But this is almost a happy ending as well. So I feel like both endings are kind of happy. I don't think he deserves to go back to the living, but that's what I'm going to choose. Because I feel like Marcus is selfish, and that's what he'd do. No place like home. Achievement. Is that it? Is that the end? So he wakes up in the hospital. Is there more? Wow. Okay, that was a really unique game. I'm glad I played that. If you want to do it for yourself, maybe make different choices, you can find it free on Steam. Thank you guys so much for watching. That was a really cool game. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!